हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नपते। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल सी सम मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द ओल्ड क्वेश्चन पेपर्स ऑफ बनारस हिंदू यूनिवर्सिटी एंड दिस क्वेश्चन पेपर इट इज ऑफ द एमएससी एंट्रेंस एग्जाम ऑफ अप्लाइड माइक्रोबायोलॉजी। सो फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू आर नॉट सब्सक्राइब दिस माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नपते, don't forget to subscribe this channel so that you will get notifications regarding the further videos of multiple choice questions on the old question papers. See, this is the instructions for this multiple choice question paper of MSc entrance exam of MSc applied microbiology, and this question paper it is taken from the that is from Banaras Hindu University. So this paper, so here this is the total number of questions here, 150 questions, and full marks for this question paper it is 450, and duration or time for this exam is 2.5 hours. So here that is the questions, time and total marks of this entrance exam for this MSc applied microbiology. That means each question it carries 3 marks. And the another important information or notice is here, if more than one alternative answer seem to be approximate to the correct answer, then you have to choose the closest one. तो यदि एकाधिक वैकल्पिक उत्तर सही उत्तर के निकट प्रतीत हो तो निकटतम सही उत्तर आपको चूज करना है। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम दिस ओल्ड क्वेश्चन पेपर। हियर द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज 5-bromouracil एक्ट एज अ म्यूटेजन बाय पेयरिंग विथ। सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दैट इज 5-bromouracil act as a mutagen by pairing with. The first option is adenine, second option is guanine, third option is cytosine, and fourth option is thymine. So friends, the correct answer of this question is adenine. Because so this is the correct answer for this question, because here that 5-bromouracil it is a brominated derivative of uracil, and this 5-bromouracil it is the base analog of the thymine nitrogen base, and this base analog that is 5-bromouracil it is present in 2 different forms. One is the normal form, and this normal form it resembles with the thymine and therefore it pairs with adenine. Then another form of this 5-bromouracil which is a rare form that resembles cytosine, and that's why it pairs with the guanine. Lekin yahan pe ye dono bhi option waise dekha jaye to correct answer hai, lekin agar hum normal form agar hum dekhenge 5-bromouracil ka to uska pairing ho jayega adenine ke sath. So isliye yahan pe hum ye correct answer iska consider kar rahe hain. So that's why the correct answer of this question 1 is adenine. Now the second question is, an organism capable of carrying out butanol fermentation is. So the correct answer of the second question is, that is Clostridium acetobutylicum. So this one is the correct answer for this question number 2, and that is this Clostridium acetobutylicum it carries out the butanol fermentation, and that butanol fermentation or it is the ABE type of fermentation. ABE type of fermentation, it means A stands for acetone, then B stands for butanol, and E stands for ethanol. So ABE fermentation, it means acetone, butanol and ethanol fermentation. And this ABE fermentation, it is carried out by this Clostridium acetobutylicum. So the correct answer of this question number 2 is 3. Okay, Now the next question, friends, here that question number 3 and 4 is missing. So we will see question number 5. So that question number 5 is, live vaccines are available against the following viral disease. So the correct answer of this question is, that is the, so this question, live vaccines are available against the following viral disease, and the correct answer of this question is measles. So this live vaccines are available for this measles, which is a viral disease. So this MMR, so that vaccine name is MMR, or that is called as the measles, mumps and rubella. It is a trivalent vaccine, MMR, and that MMR, it stands for measles, mumps and rubella. And another that disease for which that live vaccines are available, that is called as varicella vaccines or the chickenpox. So the correct answer for this question number 5 is measles. Now the next question is, antigenic variation is most extensive in. So friends, and what is meant by antigenic variation? So antigenic variation, it is also called as antigenic alteration. And this antigenic variation or antigenic alteration, it refers to the mechanism by which an infectious agent, that may be a protozoan, that may be a bacteria, or that may be a virus, they alters the proteins or carbohydrates which are present on their surface, and that's why they avoids the host immune responses. So in this way, this is the making of one of the mechanism of antigenic escape. So in by making the changes in their protein or carbohydrates which are present on the surface, these viruses, they protect themselves from the human or immune response. So the antigenic variation, it is more effective, or that viruses which has the RNA as the genetic material, so they had the faster rate of antigenic variation as compared to the DNA viruses. इसका मतलब है जो RNA viruses है, मतलब जिन viruses में RNA एक genetic material है, ऐसे viruses में जो antigenic variations का जो rate है वो ज्यादा रहता है, मतलब इनमें ज्यादा changes, जल्दी changes हो जाते हैं उनके genetic material में. So that's why antigenic variation, it is most extensive in. So it is most extensive in RNA viruses. लेकिन अभी हमें पता करना है कि इनमें से RNA viruses कौन से है. तो influenza virus ये जो है, ये single stranded RNA virus है. उसके बाद, then this smallpox virus, it is a double stranded DNA virus. And then this measles virus, it is again single stranded RNA virus. And this herpes virus, it is a double stranded DNA virus. तो अभी ये जो दो options है, influenza virus which has the single stranded RNA as a genetic material, and this measles virus, it also has the single stranded RNA as a genetic material. तो ये दोनों भी correct है, लेकिन पहला जो option है ये पहले आया है, इसलिए हम इसे correct option consider करेंगे. So this antigenic variation is most extensive in influenza viruses. और ये कौन से basis पे हम find out कर रहे हैं कि जो RNA viruses है इनमें antigenic variation ज्यादा fast होता है. तो influenza virus है RNA viruses है, measles virus भी RNA viruses है, लेकिन हमें एक ही correct option choose करना है, तो ये हम correct करेंगे. ओके, तो ये हो गया question number 6. Then question number 7 is, which of the following is not a DNA virus? तो ऐसे question जब भी exam में आते हैं, entrance exam में आते हैं, तो पहले आपको जब आप स्टडी करेंगे आपको पता होना चाहिए डीएनए वायरसेस के एग्जांपल्स एंड आरएनए वायरसेस के एग्जांपल्स. उसमें भी हम और थोड़ा डिटेल जाएंगे, तो दैट आरएनए वायरसेस व्हिच हैज द डबल स्ट्रैंडेड डीएनए वायरस एज अ जेनेटिक मटेरियल, देन दैट आरएनए वायरसेस व्हिच हैज अ सिंगल स्ट्रैंडेड डीएनए एज अ जेनेटिक मटेरियल, देन आरएनए दैट वायरसेस व्हिच हैज द डबल स्ट्रैंडेड आरएनए एज अ जेनेटिक मटेरियल, और वायरसेस व्हिच हैज द सिंगल स्ट्रैंडेड आरएनए एज अ जेनेटिक मटेरियल. तो यहां पे क्वेश्चन है, which of the following is not a DNA virus? So the question options for this question, one is SV40, option 2 is T4 phage, option 3 is tobacco mosaic virus, and option 4 is adenovirus. So friends, if you know, so DNA viruses kaun se hai, सो डबल स्ट्रैंडेड डीएनए वायरसेस के एग्जांपल्स है एडिनो वायरस, उसके बाद हर्प्स वायरस एंड पॉक्स वायरसेस। ये जो तीन वायरसेस है इनमें डबल स्ट्रैंडेड डीएनए एज अ जेनेटिक मटीरियल है। सिंगल स्ट्रैंडेड डीएनए वायरसेस के एग्जांपल कौन से हैं? पार्वो वायरसेस एंड कॉलीफाजेस। कॉलीफाजेस मींस फाजेस, दीज आर नथिंग बट द वायरसेस व्हिच इन्फेक्ट द बैक्टीरिया, एंड कॉलीफाजेस मींस दीज आर द बैक्टीरियल वायरसेस व्हिच इन्फेक्ट द कोलीफॉर्म बैक्टीरिया, दैट्स व्हाई दीज वायरसेस आर कॉल्ड एज कॉलीफाजेस। तो ये हो गए डबल स्टैंडर्ड, दैट इज सिंगल स्टैंडर्ड डीएनए वायरसेस के एग्जांपल। आरएनए वायरसेस कौन से हैं? सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द इंटरनेशनल कमिटी ऑन टैक्सोनॉमी ऑफ वायरसेस, दीज आरएनए वायरसेस आर डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री टाइप्स, ग्रुप 3 आरएनए वायरसेस, ग्रुप 4 आरएनए वायरसेस एंड ग्रुप 5 आरएनए वायरसेस। सो एग्जांपल्स ऑफ आरएनए वायरसेस इंक्लूड्स SARS वायरसेस, दैट इज सीवियर एक्वायर्ड रेस्पिरेटरी सिंड्रोम वायरसेस, और दीज आर कॉल्ड एज द कोरोना वायरसेस, देन इन्फ्लुएंजा वायरसेस एंड हेपेटाइटिस सी वायरसेस एज वेल एज HIV, दीज आर कॉल्ड एज द आरएनए वायरसेस। व्हाई? बिकॉज द जेनेटिक मटीरियल इन दिस वायरसेस इज आरएनए न्यूक्लिक एसिड। लेकिन यहाँ पे SV40 का अगर हम जीनोम देखेंगे या फिर जेनेटिक मटेरियल देखेंगे तो ये है इसमें क्लोज्ड सर्कुलर डबल स्टैंडर्ड डीएनए मॉलिक्यूल। T4 फाज जो है इट इज आल्सो अ कोलीफाज और बैक्टीरियल वायरस, और इसमें जेनेटिक मटेरियल है डबल स्टैंडर्ड डीएनए वायरस। टोबैको मोजैक वायरस में जो जेनेटिक मटेरियल है वो है सिंगल स्टैंडर्ड आरएनए वायरस, और एडिनो वायरसेस में जो जेनेटिक मटेरियल है वो है डबल स्टैंडर्ड डीएनए वायरस। तो क्वेश्चन क्या है हमारा, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट ए डीएनए वायरस। तो यहाँ पे ये जो टोबैको मोजैक वायरस है इसमें जो जेनेटिक मटेरियल है वो है सिंगल स्टैंडर्ड आरएनए वायरस। सो दैट्स व्हाई द करेक्ट आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 इज 3। ओके, सो द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज ड्यूरिंग मियोसिस क्रॉसिंग ओवर मोस्टली ऑकर्स ड्यूरिंग। सो द करेक्ट आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 इज दैट इज एन प्रोफेज 1। सो व्हाट इज मीन बाय क्रॉसिंग ओवर? So crossing over, it is nothing but the process in which that two homologous non-sister chromatids, they pair with each other and they exchange different segments of the genetic material, which results into the formation of two recombinant chromosomes. And this crossing over, it is takes place during the prophase 1. So the correct answer of this question number 8 is prophase 1. The next question is question number 9, that is human papilloma virus causes which of the following? So actually these are the names of diseases here: hepatitis, then cervical cancer, AIDS, that is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, or oral cancer. So the correct answer of this question number 9 is cervical cancer. So this HPV, or that is called as human papilloma virus, it causes this cervical cancer. That is the cancer in female genital organs or in vagina. So again friends, that question number 10 and 11 is missing. So we will see question number 12. So that question number 12 is, which of the following has a double stranded DNA genome? So the option 1 is cauliflower mosaic virus. Option 2 is cytomegalovirus. Option 3 is viroid, and option 4 is tomato leaf curl virus, that is called as TLCV. So the correct answer of this question number 12 is that is cauliflower mosaic virus. So this cauliflower mosaic virus, it has a double stranded DNA as a genetic material. Okay, so this in cytomegalovirus also there is a double stranded DNA as a genetic material is there, but the correct option is option 1. So that's why we are considering this option 1 as a correct answer for this question 12. Then viroids, they also has DNA or RNA as a genetic material. And this tomato leaf curl virus, it has single stranded DNA as a genetic material. So the double stranded DNA as a genetic material, it is present in cauliflower mosaic virus. Now question number 13 is, ergot disease is caused by? So the correct answer of this question, it is a plant disease, and the correct answer for this question number 13 is claviceps. The complete name, genus and species name of these claviceps, it is the Claviceps fusiformis. It is a fungal disease. So ergot is a fungal disease and it is caused by these claviceps. So that's why the correct answer for this question number 13 is 1. Now question number 14 is, the proton motive force drives protons across microbial membranes and the energy is used to synthesize ATP in a process known as. So the correct answer for this question is option 1, that is called as chemiosmosis. So this is the name of that process which synthesizes ATP from the or by using this proton motive force. Okay. So the next question is question number 15. So question number 15 is, all of the following apply to bacterial plasmids except. So plasmids, these are the extra chromosomal genetic material which have their own replicating capacity. Okay, the correct option, first option is, they are self-replicating loops of DNA. They have 10 to 15 genes. They are required in bacterial conjugation. And fourth option is, they are essential for the survival of the organism. So friends, if you see the definition of plasmids, that definition is, plasmids are self-replicating closed circular DNA molecules or extra chromosomal DNA molecules. So this is the correct option regarding these plasmids, that they are self-replicating loops of DNA. This is also correct. They have 10 to 15 genes. And this is also correct, that is, they are required in bacterial conjugation. But the non-correct option for this question is, they are essential for survival of the organism. That is not necessary, because that bacterial or organisms, they have their own DNA molecule, the main DNA or chromosome, and that is essential for the survival of that organism. So all of the following apply to bacterial plasmids except they are essential for survival of the organism. So that's why this fourth option, it is the correct option for this question. So this one is the correct option, that is, they are essential for the survival of organism. Okay. So the next question is, that is question number 17, UV light causes mutation in bacteria by, option A, causing frameshift mutation, causing inversion, causing dimerization of adjacent thymine residues, and fourth option is causing transition. So friends, the correct answer for this question number 17 is causing dimerization of adjacent thymine residues, because when that DNA molecule or bacteria get exposed to this ultraviolet light, so it results into the mutation, and that results into the formation of thymine dimers. So that is called, the correct answer is here third option. Question number 18 is, all except the following is true for Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So Agrobacterium tumefaciens, it consists of one plasmid, that is called as TI plasmid, or it is called as the tumor inducing plasmid. So it is correct for this Agrobacterium tumefaciens, and it causes or it carries oncogene on its plasmid. So as the name suggests here, TI plasmid means tumor inducing, and tumor inducing, that is the gene which causes the cancer, and that's why that gene is called as oncogene. So oncogenes are those genes which are responsible for the causation of cancer, and it causes crown gall disease. So this Agrobacterium tumefaciens, it is a causative agent of this crown gall disease. So this is also the correct for this Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So it is except that it is a gram positive bacterium. So the all except this, it is a gram positive bacterium, following is true from the Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So the correct answer for this question is this one. It is a gram positive bacterium. Okay. So this is question number 18. So the next question is, the capsular material produced by bacteria generally consists of, option A, option 1, lipids, option 2, polysaccharides, option 3, fatty acids, and option 4, nucleic acids. So the capsular material, which is the outermost covering of the bacterial structure, that mainly made up of polysaccharides. So that's why the correct answer of this question number 19 is polysaccharides. So friends, we have seen near about 15 to 19 questions here, and with answers and with explanation. So Hope this you like this video, and don't forget to share with your friends. And if you have not subscribed this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, so kindly subscribe this YouTube channel, so you will get notifications regarding the upcoming videos on old question papers. So thank you. So remaining questions we will see in next lecture. Thank you.